Hello, boys and girls, I guess, as well. Mario, you're watching my 100% now technically blind playthrough of Mario Plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle for the Nintendo Switch. This is my 100% playthrough, and as you can see in the last episode, we conquered the final boss battle, which made our castle turn golden. This just tells us about the stuff we already unlocked, like secret chapters, challenges, look for the ultimate ones at Peach's Castle, co-op mode, and some other stuff. And I guess there's even more challenges or something, I don't know, but anyway. All we can say is, we still have quite a bit of stuff to do, and... again, I have a very particular order I want to do this, to make sure that I get the maximum use of all my collectibles. And now that we're back in Peach's Castle, the first time we do have a new cutscene. Pay attention, yes, we were awesome and heroically defeated the Maybug. Okay, so they do still call it the Mega Bug, it just merged with Bowser to call Mega Dragon Bowser. But we still have work to do. First, we need to explore the Mushroom Kingdom for places to use my new talent, Dig. I'd start with the Lava Pit. There's not just digging to do with the Lava Pit. It seems there are a lot of corrupted rabbits for us to find and liberate as well. Finally, tuned sensors also detect increased activity of Body Dome and 4 ultimate challenge healers near Peach's Castle. Started good, so let's go. So you've unlocked the dig action, finally. And now we have apparently ultimate challenges that I'd not even heard about. There were special challenges before this, but now there's ultimate challenges as well. Anyways, we finally get to use this first part here, where we can break, reveal a secret path, which will head to a secret cannon, which actually just teleports us off the map. Ah, I see, so this is where the challenges take place. So they have a couple of ultimate challenges for us, which are like even higher tier than the ultimate challenges. So yeah, I guess there is a lot more to do still. That just proves I still haven't done most of the game, and I still have to clean up extra challenges after that. I don't know what I'm gonna do, honestly, after that, but I think for now that we're into the game, we should start by at least unlocking stuff to see where these challenges are available. And sure enough, looks like those drills weren't actually used for anything important. Instead, they were just required to unlock even harder versions of the challenges we already have. So we pretty much just have to use our drill ability throughout the world in various locations. And using the stuff apparently raises cannons, which we can use to get to all the challenges. I will be revealing those now in this video right now. Just to obviously get this out of the way so I don't have to do it later. Also to make it a bit easier, but also for the fact that I think if I do this over doing it the other way, I think I could just play them from the washing machine instead of playing them from the map, but who knows. Of course, in order for that to work, I need to actually like make sure I go to the challenges first. If it turns out that that doesn't work, then I guess that's fine, we'll take a while. Anyway, these will probably all be done in one episode, and we'll probably also wait until we have, like, the maximum orbs before we go there, because obviously we still need to power up our orbs on all of our characters. You might have noticed our powers were still kind of lacking in some of the battles. In addition to our just our raw weapon power as well, from not having the best weapons, they were kind of locked behind a lot of stuff, and especially behind that big boss battle. But now that we have that done, we can actually buy the new weapons. And that's actually one thing I think I should do, is buy weapons for our characters. Just like I always do, though, when I buy the weapons, I will always buy them like I do before. So, first, for Mario, we're gonna get his first semi-ultimate weapon on his primary side, which is the Phantom Barrel. We'll equip that. Then we'll see that there's an even higher tier of secondary weapons later. And yeah, now we have a hammer. I'm gonna get this one. And then for secondary weapons, on Peach's side, I will get you. Looks like the move range has been increased as well as the damage on it. We'll give you push for now. I'll just get you that, whatever. Because I like Yoshi a lot, I'm gonna give him his weapon next. He's gonna exclusively have ink since he's been doing really well with that. So that's what we're gonna give him. Then, once I'm done, I'm gonna give some power weapons for some characters I know are going to be good in the later game. Starting with Rabbit Mario, because I've used him quite a bit next. And then, I will do Luigi next, because he's also going to be used quite a bit, actually, in some of these later battles. So we're upgrading all of their weapons so that they stay in. And then from there, we'll kind of just have to go down. I think what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go down each character's list of stuff that they can do. And start by equipping them all with their primary weapon upgrades. And then if I still have money after that, I'll equip them with all of their secondary weapon upgrades. And Peach, I'm going to give you freeze just because that's probably more useful. You're going to get stone because I don't think we have a character with that ability yet. Okay, now that we're moved back to here, we're going to do a secondary weapon on this tier. If you're wondering where a lot of the money grind came from, well, that's because, yes, I did technically do a lot of morning grinding, but also just doing the challenges naturally gave me a lot of money. But the main reason I did it is because I technically don't want the game to be fully 100% complete necessarily. I guess what I mean by that is I personally don't consider the game to be fully complete until we buy every single weapon. Even if we're not going to use it, I just thought it'd be cool to do. Obviously, it costs a lot of money to buy every single weapon. And it's not something you would normally do in a game, but I thought it'd be fun to try. Hey. This is an executor. I'm gonna get that. Even though this one looks exactly like Mario. We'll probably buy the other ones later, though. Okay, and there we go. We got all that done. I guess one other thing we have to... I'll just wait to do that until I get into the lava pit. Because it's not gonna really matter until we get into the lava pit, though. I've decided, though, because I like this team cop... Two of my favorite characters from the series, Yoshi obviously like my primary favorite, and from just this game, Rabbit Peach is also a really good of mine. I think this is going to be the party I use for most of the game. If I can use it to do chapters, I will certainly do that. If it turns out I can't get that, then that's fine. Oh. Wait, I just realized that. Oh, yeah, that's right. We have to... This first. We could go here and get another switch to go somewhere else. So, yeah, these basically are the hidden cannons to find the hidden challenges from. I'm just doing the puzzles for them now so that we can save time later. There we go. And I think by opening them this way, we actually get access to the other stuff. Obviously, if you were doing a normal playthrough, you'd probably want to just do these as you walk up to them, just so you don't have to go back to the thing every time. But then again, after, like, having my game crash a whole bunch, it's like, ugh, what's the point? If it's just gonna not do anything. For those of you who don't know what an amiibo is, by the way, it's like a system for the meal stuff, but if anybody's wondering what that thing does, is it's a very specific thing that I can't use, because what it basically does is it locks gear for one character as well as their rabbit counterpart, or actually no, it's supposed to be for just the rabbits, but it also locks gear for their Mario counterpart, and basically what it does is it locks gear earlier in the game. So as you would normally have to go through chapter 1 to get through some of the stuff, you could pretty much just redeem a bunch of these and have a bunch of gear on our characters by the start of the third world. I don't know what exactly it changes after that, but other than that, yeah. Okay, so this one actually gives us a chest, so... Oh, this one's for spawning. That's the one we got in the museum. I think we will go ahead, and once we've confirmed 100% completion, I'll probably look over all the stuff to make sure. If you're wondering why I added in extra mechanics from the other game, though, and speaking of which, I'm probably going to have to do some more money grinding. I'm not sure if I could buy all of the weapons. I'm not sure if I want to show you guys buying all the weapons, so I think what I should actually do is get a bunch of excess money, buy weapons off screen so I have exactly 10k coins, and then maybe do other stuff. Oh, I just realized I don't want to actually leave this world. I actually have to go in it. Yeesh. Sorry. Sorry, this first part for getting into Lava Pit takes so long, but it's like, we still have to find the secret chapter here, and we still technically have to look at other stuff, so it's like, what do we do? So, yeah. Anyway, we get to finally explore around the lava pit, and most of the stuff I see unlocked are probably going to be at the part before we go into Valor's Hassle, and of course the part at the very beginning, especially the part where we first got fun. There was pretty much drill things we had to do pretty much everywhere, so there's gonna be a lot of chests that we'll have to claim just exclusively using the drill. Oh, they added in an extra bridge. Cool. Alright. No, that is not a glitch, by the way, or by video. Yeah, you might have noticed if you try and drill too fast within one or another, it does not play the sound. Don't ask me why that is a sound bug, but it's just hilarious and something that can't be unseen now. Alright, where does this take me? I need to obviously figure out where this takes me, because so we have a lot of drill spots to do now. It's gonna take a while to go through all of them. Okay, that gives us a chest, and it says into the pit, and we also get a bridge that unlocks access to something else. Next of it, we can fight these blocks from the... Oh, okay, yeah, all right. So now this leads back to where we were, I think, about a few chapters into this place. So now we're going to take the backwards pipe, because there's probably more chests back there. What am I kidding? There probably is more chests back there. This is kind of a weird way we have to do this world, but then again, it's not like we can do it without doing anything else right now. But yeah, honestly, that was kind of funny. Using a drill, for some reason, it glitches if you, like, it just doesn't make the noise. If you use it too many times in quick succession, it's kind of interesting. The block breaking one is no problem. You can pretty much do that as many times as you want, and it will never glitch out. Well, and that's actually kind of interesting that they didn't have enough space to make it replay several times. I wonder why. Who knows? Let's just keep going now. We need to figure out where everything is. Again, by the way, to avoid confusion, I'm not going to be doing any challenges in this part. This is going to be exclusively cleaning up World 4. Because I learned from doing the World 1 cleanup that, it gets kind of shaky, especially when you waste your time going around doing other stuff. So I figure if I somehow kept that all into one episode, it'd be a lot easier. But anyways, expect this to probably be a very long world, because World 4 is typically really long. Well, usually the last world is like the largest of the world, so be surprised if it also took the longest to explore. Okay, there is a drill spot there, which makes me believe that this is gonna spawn a chest. Nope, it does not. It just gives me extra coins. I was hoping that would be something different. But no, that does not do anything. I guess there really is no chest or block you can push here anyway, so it's not like it was gonna mean anything. Oh, thanks, Yoshi. Anyway, still kind of exploring around. If you're wondering what happened the last video, I don't really have to talk much about. I think I already mentioned we finished the game fully. And so now we're just exploring and kind of taking a chill break, I guess. Because exploring, I guess, is chill. I don't know what else to say. Alright. Yeah. Okay, that's a chest we already got. Helps to check, though. Sometimes you miss chests. I feel like I did miss a couple of chests here that weren't ones that you had to use drill for. But we'll be able to catch up with those, of course, once we get other stuff done. That being said, that first drill spot we found pretty much immediately revealed, like, three chests pretty much immediately. So, you can only imagine there'll be more. This is a blocks puzzle thing, which I pretty much already did, so I'm gonna just go straight over here instead. And looks like that chest has already been collected. And you know what? Sure, I will destroy all the blocks, because there is a chance that one of these ends up being a chest. Well, actually, it was a chest. That part was correct, but we already got the chest out. By destroying the block before, obviously, when we first came here. Anyway, keep exploring. Other than that, not much can be done here. I will say, though, the extra weapons should hopefully help us get through a lot of the later parts of the game. That's a chest already gotten. Pretty much have to take this pipe to even get over here. And over here too. But we've already seen quite a few crazy puzzles we had to do here. I'm just setting this block up in a way so that we can use it to get a mushroom on the other side, but also get the other stuff over here. Just kind of tricky battles so far. I did have a video when saying the battles are getting trickier or whatever, is my title or whatever. It's like one of my subtitles. and I didn't say that for like a dumb reason. The battles do get really tough by the fourth world and really force you to think out your plan. I think I did pretty well though, considering I haven't done the game in a while. To only miss golds on two of the chapters is actually pretty impressive, and honestly, I'm not even surprised what happened there. Both of those were considered some of the hardest chapters in the game, and they were surprisingly tight for the teammates to do. I thought it was going to be another 12 turn battle thing, and maybe it was initially in the original game, but now, for some reason, defeated Mmer in 7 turns the golden medal icon, though it doesn't really matter at that point, because typically your game, but like, even still, it's kind of tricky. Keeping all the imperators alive for 7 turns, but also finishing Bowser within those 7 turns. That means on average, you need to defeat him every other turn, which is kind of difficult to do. And you could kind of see why I buffed Mario with M power at the start. Well, we probably needed that 70% M power buff if we wanted to stand a chance of even attack M team to defeat Bowser. And she also just helps out a lot with that too, because like being able to guarantee quit and then set it up along with the other pills just makes it so much easier to get through that battle. Oh, here's our second actual spot we can go. Move that down first. See, I wasn't joking. That is not just a side bug thing. It does not make a noise if you drill hell within a quick succession. Anyways, we found our solar chest here. Burning butts. Okay. Oh, some more drill stuff to do. Okay, that one didn't even make the noise when I, because the pipe noise apparently played over that. So like, that is fine. I realized that Dairy Dean doesn't always play. Unless you wait a bit. I guess we could have ignored going through that, but I have to check. At least make sure that there's not anything missing. Because I've missed quite a few chests by just not looking hard enough at the stuff. Oh my. Oh yeah, I forgot about this battle area. So I think we got shot straight past this battle area, so I wanted to go backwards and make sure I'm not in. Oh, wait. Ah, great. This may actually be the forward path. Whoops. Ugh. Now I'm feeling like I'm going through confusion loop. Okay, no, alright. Well, considering how long that puzzle took from before to do, I feel like now it's actually faster to secret shortcut. In fact, it probably was faster to just stay on that secret path. I was just worried I would miss a chest, so I went back to make sure. But I guess since this is faster, and I may as well take the secret shortcut. Also, I haven't quite done a lot of 100% runs enough, so I wouldn't know, like, oh, maybe we could just reload to Peach's castle and just teleport to an area entirely, and because of that, get a faster defeat of this particular chapter. Yeah. Okay, I guess best we do get most of the stuff. All that gave us coins again. We're probably going to be coming up to the secret chapter soon now. It can't hide from us forever. Oh! Okay, well, this is different. I completely missed this part. Alright. Got a big place on this. There's gotten to be a few chests here. In fact, yeah. So this was available from the beginning. This did not require a chest set. I figured that I would miss something. because, like, beyond level 3, I just don't know where anything is in terms of the chest collectibles. Yeah. Kinda tricky, but thankfully it didn't seem to have any orbs, so it didn't cost me anything. Alright, then. I like how they still make you do this puzzle for no reason. It's like, oh, you can't just cheese through here either. You have to actually do the puzzle. Hint, hint. Okay. This part does feel a bit awkward. You know what? Maybe I will warp to Peach's castle and see if there's a way to teleport fastest. Because it's probably faster than actually trying to go for that dumb puzzle again. But then it might be slower, because gosh, who knows what could happen. Alright. Let's see, number 2, minecart VM, entry 4, uphill lava trail, castle gates. That's not really much to go through, and factory 4 is just behind the other stuff, so I think I'll pick uphill lava trail and I guess just go backwards and then make forwards to the right. I don't care, honestly, what's gonna happen, even if it ends up taking longer. It's like, I'll take anything to not have to do any of those super long puzzles again, just to get back down to the other area. That's actually one part I would legit cut out, because it's like, it's all a bit better, but I figured instead, I'll do this. Alright, so where's the, okay, that's coming from that way. So we want to go back here. This is where we'll figure out how far we have to go back. Or actually, well, I guess this kind of works. Yeah, I guess it definitely does. Secret chapter is actually right here. Alright, well, I guess we're doing that now instead of waiting. Yeah, right then, well, we go, we found the secret chapter just like that. Still haven't done the orbs, because, well, we didn't have a reason to do them. Since they're getting pretty late in the game, we're probably gonna have to give high down damage bonus to a few characters as well. Ugh, dang it, Mario doesn't have enough for that skill. I was hoping he would have enough for it, but nope. Peach doesn't have enough for anything I need, so I'm just gonna wait on her. We'll probably get more of the orbs by the time we finish the game. Then, that Luigi, I think you can actually start getting high ground damage bonus in case we use you again. And then, for Luigi, I guess now he has to start working on his dash, so he's not too weak at doing that. At least get it up something. Or actually, we could just give him itchy feet range. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna change around again. We'll give him higher ground, then give him that. I've kind of changed our Luigi's build around quite a bit, but since Luigi might be used a little bit, and there is still a few more battles where we can make use of higher ground, having higher ground damage bonus might actually help out. Then for Mario, I mostly want magnet range with him. Cannot max that out though, so I won't do the lift that. And I guess Peach can either do range increase or this. I'm gonna do that first. just because it might end up being better. It says Yoshi doesn't really have any fails he could do, pretty much. We'll give him a high ground damage bonus, and then we'll have no choice but to improve the range of this. So we'll pretty much probably ignore him for a bit. It's kind of sad. We did use him a little bit, but not a lot. But Yoshi, I think I want to go for... probably finish his dash damage thing first. As well as maybe even improve his ground pound range a bit before doing this. Maybe, but... otherwise, looks like the other characters are still in kind of a shaky scenario. They just barely don't have enough for their other upgrades, so... this might be a little bit trickier than before, but... we'll have to make it work. Anyways... took a while, but we found our secret chapter. About halfway into it already. I think we'll be able to figure out what to do once we, actually explore most of the chapter first. Oh, jeez, it's amazing just even exploring this place. And I thought that Anchor chapter was very awkward in World 3. Definitely saved the hardest for last, that's for sure. Alright, our first battle, finally. We'll stick with the same team. Okay, this time... it throws us straight into a mid-boss battle. But our only requirement this time is just to defeat the Voila Trio. And for some reason, they gave us the special theme back again. Interesting. They never did that for the other battles, by the way. But anyway, I guess this is cool. This is our first time that we get to chest our slightly more upgraded and more powerful weapons. And our extra attack power stuff. Now, if we've seen most of this battle series, then we probably already know that from just playing a bunch, we want to take out Waluigi first. He does the most damage of the trio, and we want to make sure that he's defeated right away every time. But we also want to take out as many of his friends as we can as well. I actually have a cool idea. Probably should work. Yep, I can. It's gonna go over, hammer, move Mario all the way over to the side, and then use this hammer to take out this enemy just because I can. That was a bit overkill for this enemy, but that's fine because we get a golden shot. I forgot to mention the way golden shot works. I never really mentioned it directly in any battle, but I'm gonna mention it now. How it works is, if you overkill an enemy, i.e. do more damage than its health by a set amount, then your character will actually do a bit of an increase in damage. Okay, what can I do with attacking the tail? Fortunately, that won't reach, but I don't want to waste it either. So I think it's better to save Yoshi's attack for now. Oh. Except he already used his attack, and he also can't really do much of anything. We'll have no choice but to throw him here then. But it's fine, we'll at least be able to complete our main objective of taking out the first member of Geo right away. So we don't have to deal with him later. Now we just need to defeat the other two. But we also have lava to deal with as well now. Just like before that, their enemy really likes to cheat and just get all the range in the world, because he doesn't care.
Mario time!
Okay, I'm gonna move Mario first. I know I kind of do a lot of different things for taking damage from other stuff, but I think this time I'm gonna let Mario take the damage from this attack. And I think I want to try to prioritize Neil, at the very least. Okay, that canceled out my attack unless I can back online. That's probably what. Maybe I should have waited. If I had known about that freeze, I would have stopped that ability right away. Okay, well, this explosion should attack both of them. I think it's probably better that I do as much damage as I can to this enemy. Cool, we took out the supporter just from that alone. That's good. Okay, well, this is actually going pretty well so far. We've eliminated a member pretty much every turn, and I think if we can keep this up, we can actually make this work in the turn counter, probably. Let's see where she goes next. It's over there and attacks y'all. Alright. Don't have the heal up. I don't know why. I thought I didn't use a heal at all, but what can you do sometimes? Oh, Mario actually has a better move he can do. You could just move straight up to the enemy and hammer it right away. In fact, that's probably what I'm gonna do. Assuming Peach is also in range for that. If not, then I'll just have to... Yeah, okay. Well, looks like we are in the proper range. Nice zoom in. Game. I forgot to mention, when the camera zooms in, depending on the segment, it'll either signal a guaranteed hit if your attack would have missed normally, or typically with crit weapons, if you see the zoom in effect happen, that means that it's a guaranteed crit. It's a hit mechanic that you aren't really told about. It's just kind of there. Okay, I was correct. Kind of a tight battle, free turn limit, but quite a bit easier to make it work. Oh, I think I was supposed to use the shield, and I think what ended up happening is I ended up using instead. Anyway. What now? Just like any other secret chapter, it looks like once again most of the chests are going to be found here, which makes sense. This is the secret chapter, it only makes sense that they would all be here. I wonder if this will give us some healing options, I don't know. By the way, you can kind of see one problem with Mario that isn't necessarily him being weak or anything else, actually. It's not that, any of those setups. You might have those. Cannot be leave the team. That means if he just deals damage, it can be leave a lot of problems, either by making certain battles more difficult because of having to heal. Or I guess we have to get this spot done for a switch. Oh my goodness, look what we have here. It takes all the mid bosses and combines them into one big mess that I have no clue what to do. It's all of them. Literally all the mid bosses we've seen, they're all there now. In one big setup. And are they gonna cheat like they did before? Nope, they don't. They show us mercy. And for the first time in like baby history of this whole game, we actually get the mid-boss theme in the right place this time. This is honestly perfect for this battle. I am going to do a little bit of a different strategy since we know how dangerous Bowser Jr. can be. I think I want to actually set up a combo that makes him move early, even if it means doing a lot of extra damage or something, or actually just maybe focus on the ever bosses first, or just wait for him to move. Because I want to have Yoshi and Mario do both of their special attacks right away. Because I think if we can do that successfully, we can do a lot damage to the bat overall and make it go faster. It'll mean we don't get our setup the first turn, but that's fine. We can use our buffs the second turn instead. Anyways, I decided, seems like a pretty straightforward setup. We'll just move up here and honestly, we want to probably focus on dealing with the weaker ones first. If any of them get to do any turns, that might get really messy. So what I'm going to do is use the range to guarantee that this enemy dies for sure. This is actually one good reason to have a rocket, because you can fire from so far away. It's actually ridiculous. And it looks like we can fire at this enemy too, so yeah. Probably the smartest plan, take out two of the weakest mid-bosses first. So they don't do anything at the start, which will reduce our damage, and then we kind of, I was kind of hoping Bowser Jr. would move first, but this one decided to move first, but I guess that works out. He is kind of an awkward mid-boss to deal with, so if we get Caldevera early, then that might work. Okay, well, at least we did a little bit of damage. Ooh, my. Combos happening everywhere. I have no idea what happened, but Bowser Jr. lured us in. That's all that really happened, and it kind of freaked me out. Now I really don't like Mario's HP setup. So what I'm gonna do is hit range, and I should probably just move Mario right away in case I get rested. Oh, I guess I have to move it in a way that doesn't hit that sentry, because if I do, I'm just gonna take damage from the sentry. It's gonna be even more awful. So what do I do to make it guaranteed? I think probably the best solution is actually not move any of the other characters, move Yoshi instead. Take this hit on Ferris. Be a little bit of damage, but it's not really that big deal. I think the big focus right now is we need to use our crits, and we gotta deal with Bowser Jr. first. He's the most dangerous of the mid-bosses due to actually being immune to crit attacks. Oh, okay. Looked like he didn't, cancel out that threat of the sentry, so we'll probably just have to attack. I'm like, I forgot to use my buff. I was wondering why my damage was missed a lot. What do we do now? This kind of messed up my plan. You know what? I should probably still continue with my original plan, because Bowser Jr. is still the most dangerous threat. I think what we want to do is just focus on dealing with him first. And then we'll just have to move everyone from the sentries. We have to move it such a way where the angle doesn't move us into that center spot. I think to make it guaranteed, we have to team jump to get over to the spot we need. Okay, now. Okay. Yes. With that tight of a setup, I honestly am not surprised I wasn't able to evade the damage. Alright, who do I use this on? I'd probably again Bowser Jr. He's probably the most friendly, but at the same time, we could always take him out a turn later, so maybe? You know what? Caldevera kind of a bad spot for himself. We're gonna take him out instead, but I think we did pretty much what we wanted to do. We used this turn to pretty much destroy Bowser Jr. Do a lot of damage to him. Now I think what I'm gonna do is try to use combo attacks. Okay. That time there was no way to avoid that sentry. pretty much had no choice but to take the attack from it. Oh, there's more enemies coming up, apparently. If we don't hurry, they're gonna spawn in. Alright, who do we want to take the attack from this now? Probably, Peach. We also need to check characters' ranges are. Well, for the best scenario, we need to move Peach to be that close. If you're wondering, yes, I do want to try and ideally have a setup where... the other characters dash the remaining ones, but didn't seem like that was gonna work. Yeah, whatever. I guess we could technically make it barely work, but then we would have to have Mario use his hammer to make it work, so... I'm honestly kind of confused what to do now. I think before I even do any moves, I should just attack with Yoshi right now instead of waiting. And then kind of do different things depending on what damage we do. Okay, that ended up being kind of tricky, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use a sentry now rather than later. Destroy some cover, maybe open up a bit, and then make a move again. And then I was gonna see, maybe I can use this to do something to him. Oh, actually, wait. Oh, yeah, I still have Mario's turn. Alright, never mind. I know the strategy all of a sudden now. I was confused at first, but I think I know the strategy to guarantee that we do enough damage, because Mario's stomp is 100, right? So I know the strat now to finish this. I was just doing those attacks first because I wanted to know what to do from there. I think I know the plan now. Yoshi, you are going to ground pound into this particular enemy. Then we're probably going to do what I believe might be one of the more coolest looking moves in the game. We're going to have Mario move up. We're going to stomp in. I almost kind of want to Amber Bowser Jr. again, but I'm not going to do it this time. I think it might look more cooler to just point like him. In fact, I'm not sure if you can even hammer him anyways, because if he's anything like Bowser... Oh, actually, no, I did hammer Bowser a couple of times already, so yeah, I guess I could have done this differently. But anyway, yeah. It's like, we did that in 3 turns. Okay, that was actually an easier one. They gave us up to 5 turns to do that one. But anyway, kind of a cool way to end the last secret chapter, and I guess it makes sense. We'll just fight all, instead of fight one mid-boss, let's fight all of them. And I guess, those extra weapons that I unlocked... No, wait, actually, no. Those are probably something else, but... Anyway, we have... We're gonna get, now, our secret stuff that we were waiting to get before. So Mario's gonna get stomp damage. Peach might get either protection or something else. I have no clue. I think I actually wanted to have dash damage first now, considering what's been happening lately. Luigi will simply finish off higher ground damage bonus, and G will now finally get some dash damage. As in case you haven't already noticed, Luigi's dash damage is kind of weak and kind of pathetic. Not a lot you can do about it. Give Rabbid Mario a bit of higher ground damage bonus anyway. And then, alright, I'm going to give Peach a bit of dash damage as well. And you, I'd rather have one more turn with that, so I'll do that. Finally going to the next part, and then... Yoshi. That's right, we're giving you dash damage. There we go. Now we have pretty much almost max dash damage on anything, and Mario has a max powered stomp now, so that should help out a little bit. Alright. I don't know what else to do now from here. Oh, we got Megabucks. So there is, so it does literally call it Megabucks. So I wasn't joking. That technically the true name of the final battle, but it's known as Mega Dragon Bowser because it merged with Bowser to make him super broken or whatever. Yeah, that was the thing that it did. Anyway, I think if we're gonna stop early, then may as well do some other stuff first beforehand. Oh, nice. Got. Oh, nice Bowser's theme, of course. How could we forget that? And there's. Now, going all the way back to the edge, we finally get our secret statue that we. While it only makes sense, we have to go all the way over to the end of the first part, and then all the way back to the start of this chapter, just to get this one switch that we now have to place somewhere. Yeah, it looks like we actually can't even do that, so I forgot where the red switch is. Ooh, need to figure out where that is quickly. Okay, well, I know that can't be the switch, though, because that was the entrance to the chapter. In fact, I can't even go anywhere other than here, so we'll have to find a different place for this. Anyways, here's what I'm thinking. I think we're gonna get the the chests here. Jeez, I cannot talk. Oh, I think I have to get it from the top part. That's why it's messing up. I imagine what we actually need to do is move that all the way from the top level and have it fall a full level down to actually a chest. My goodness, they make you go through this area pretty much twice just to get one chest. Well, actually, no, not just one chest, I guess, technically. It's more than one chest, but like, kind of crazy. They make you drop this chest from here, and then you gotta drop it like 15 feet down so it falls completely into another level, and then take the switch back with you. So you can eventually use it to finally open those three tests at the end, which, by the way, one of those is probably gonna contain orbs, knowing what I know about this game. Because, well, I just know that kind of thing just has to happen. Because, like, one of those chests pretty much is guaranteed to have orbs, because it's like, at that point, you kind of want them anyway. Anyways, now we can finally push this switch from here down over to this area here on this side of the area. By the way, I'm not necessarily as worried with having to do this part in two episodes, even if it ends up taking longer, but one thing I do want to do is try to at least finish the main game this week for sure. And maybe ideally, okay, so I can get a little bit, start working on a little bit of Donkey Kong Adventure right away, because I am very excited to try that. Anyway, get two silvers here now. First, we have Bowser's Castle gold artwork. Then another gold item, probably. No, it's a Mega Dragon Bowser model in gold. Then we have, not surprised in the slightest, 20 power orbs, because it seems like we pretty much have to get that after the end of each major chapter. It's almost like we're not allowed to have that. All right. What do we have here with Peach now? I think I want her to focus more on getting her abilities set up, probably. Nothing for you. Luigi gets dash damage. And Mario, I'll just give you some more higher ground damage bonus, because why the heck not at this point? Each can't get dash damage, so I'll wait. Yoshi pretty much has all of his stuff done, so now he's gonna start building high ground damage bonus. If you're wondering why I haven't been building this a lot, is it's actually only around a 20 to 60% damage increase, and I think pins are probably the main way you get most of the damage increase. On top of it, this doesn't always work in most of the battles anyways. Like, that big boss battle we did on the right side area, you can't even use the high ground damage bonus half of the time in that final boss battle, so having that actually isn't gonna be that useful in the long run. If anything, you want more ability power to make that work better. Alright, well, I don't want this video to take forever, obviously, because of, like, YouTube selfs and also wanting my videos to be short, so I'm gonna make this a two-parter for this cleanup, unfortunately. But don't worry, it'll probably all go back to being long again, because, of course, we're still gonna have to do all of World Force challenges, and that's gonna be fun. Probably gonna be very difficult, yeah, but anyways, I want to at least finish this part, so yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Leave a like if you enjoyed, by the way, comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.